And yo, I am the star in any room that I stand in. I am the standout, you just my stand-in. These bitches copy my homework.
What's up, babes? Welcome back to my channel. Today is gonna be like a very interesting topic. Like, the topic that we're gonna talk about today, I feel like a lot of girls wanna know, so I'm gonna give it to the girls. But make sure before we get into the video, you like, comment, and subscribe, period. So today we're gonna be talking about being a bottle girl, being a nightlife, just like the pros and cons and a lot that comes with it, because everybody wanna be a bottle girl. Like, every girl I've been friends with, like, oh, like, that's me, like, I wanna be a bottle girl, like, this, that. But I don't think y'all really know what be going on behind the scenes. So, guess what I'm about to do? I'm about to spill the tea. But today we're giving natural money, you know. So we're gonna get into the video. First of all, I wasn't even bottle girl for that long. I was only bottle girl for a year. And after that year, I realized that it wasn't really for me. Like, it was just a lot of things that I did not want to do. That was not my character, that a lot of other girls was doing in the bottle girl industry. And I'm just being real. Like, it's certain stuff people would do for money that I wasn't willing to do. And that kind of like made me get out of the bottle industry. Because, yeah. So, I got a doubt in my notes, y'all. So, we're going to talk about the cons. Like, what's the cons to being a bottle girl first? So the first kind is a hit or miss. Like, it really is a hit or miss. Like, you can have really, really good nights, and you can have really, 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 really slow nights. Like, it can be nights where you make a lot of money, and it can be nights where you don't make no money. There's been nights that I went to the club, and I drove 30 minutes from my house, and I didn't make no money. No hourly wage, no nothing. And I just feel like if I'm driving 30 minutes, I should at least make some gas money. But sometimes I wouldn't even make that. And that's why I was just like, is this really worth it? Like, is it really, I don't know. It was just at a point in my life where I was like, what am I doing by being a bottle girl? Like, how is it helping me in my life? Besides getting fast money. Because off-ass money is not good money. So that's another thing. It's a hit or miss. Like, you really can make a lot of money being a bottle girl. You really can. But you really can make no money. And it was like some days where I would go in back to back to back to back. And I wouldn't make no money. Like, that's just frustrating. Because now I'm really wasting my time. Like, coming up here, driving up here, doing all this. And I'm not making no money. Like, come on now. And then another con is you make the most money on the weekends. So, you make a lot of your money on the weekends. So, you're not really going to have as much free time on the weekend. You're really not going to be able to really have the weekends to yourself because you're going to be so busy working. Because you got to think about it. Everybody goes to the club mostly on the weekend when they don't have work, because people be working during the week, so they come on the weekend. And I guess it could be like a good thing and a bad thing, but I like to have my weekends to myself, to relax, to recruit, to like get myself together. So it was just kind of like, dang, I was going to work Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and it wasn't like I was getting off at a reasonable time. I would get off at 3 to 4 a.m. when the club closed at 2. And we gotta clean, baby. So it's like, I'm getting off at 4 a.m. in the morning and I gotta go back in the next day. Like, are you serious? And then if you're not making no money, sometimes I'm like, I'm not going. I'm calling out. Because it's wasting my time. Like, I'm just, yeah. I do not miss it at all. And another thing is, like, people get real aggressive when they're drunk. Like, I don't think people understand, like, I'm your server, I'm your bottle girl. They get real aggressive to the point where they want to be all up on you, where they want to touch you, where they want to be all buddy. And me personally, I'm not a type of buddy person unless you my man, unless you my boyfriend. Like, I don't like people trying to touch me, trying to be all up on me, trying to be this. I don't like that. Like, you keep your distance, I'ma keep mine. Like, I'm here to be your server. Why are you trying to touch my butt? Why are you trying to be all up on me? Why are you trying to do this? Why are you trying to do that? I would just get annoyed when people try to do that to me, because it's like, what is your motive? What was the point of that? And then, you know what would be so... It would be so funny, y'all, when people would get aggressive with me because their card didn't buy. Baby, you knew you should have had that money when you came outside. That's not my fault. I'm just here to get the payment.
Out of pocket for that shit. Way out of pocket. What do you gain from that?
Because regardless, you're not leaving until you pack. So, yeah, you better call your homeboys, do whatever you gotta do, but you gotta pay regardless. And that's just that. Regardless how you feel about it. But yeah, like, people are just weird. Like, niggas is weird. Niggas be acting thirsty. Like, I don't like that. So, another thing is, it would be drama. Like, y'all, it would be drama. I am not a drama girl. I don't like drama. I don't like to be in drama. I don't like when people try to pull me in drama. It would be drama between girls messing with the promoters, girls messing with the owners, girls stealing money, girls doing all of this, just doing all of this stuff just to get some money.
I don't, you know what I'm saying? It ain't going, nah, it ain't going to work.
That's why I'm like, bro, y'all doing all of this just to get some money. Like, y'all beefing. Like, sometimes the older girls will be beefing with the younger girls because they feel like the younger girls is trying to take their spot. Like, man, I'm here to get a bag too. We just all trying to get our money. Like, and girls will really act a certain way towards you and trying to put you in drama just because they older than you and they've been doing this longer than you. And that's what I don't like. Like, I'm not the type of girl. I'm not the type of girl that has to kiss anybody but to get where I need to be. So when girls will try to come at me like, I need to do that, I'm not doing that. Like, I don't gotta do that. And I had to realize, like, some of them girls, they really needed it more than me. Like, that's why I really got out of it, because you need it more than me, because you obviously doing too much all the time, and I'm not messing with that. No. That's another thing, like, girls will be having intercourse with the owners, like, just so they can get more money. The girls will be messing with the promoters to get the good tables. Like, it's a lot. Like, I got story for days, y'all. Like, I really got stories. Like, nightlife is not as glamorous as people make it seem. It's what I'm basically trying to say. And then another thing I didn't like is, if you're a bottle girl, you have to book tables. You have to know people. You have to know how to book tables. But my thing was always, if you're a promoter, your main job is to book a table. Regardless, I'm a bottle girl. I'm supposed to serve them. I'm supposed to serve the people that you bring in the building. Now, I'm not saying I'm not going to book no tables at all, but it is your main job to book tables. And the promoter will always try to put on the bottle girls like, y'all don't book no tables, y'all getting free money.
What do you mean by that?
Do you not know what a bottle girl is? A bottle girl is a server job. Yes, we're supposed to promote. Yes, we're supposed to bring people out. But you're the promoter. Do you not know the definition of a promoter? Like, yo, I say, y'all, that used to, like, piss me off low-key, because I can book a table. I can book a table. I have booked a table at everywhere I work at. Anybody can vouch for that. But don't expect me to be overdoing it. And I'm not even making no money like that. That's my thing. You want me to overdo it, and I'm not even making what I want to make? Yeah, no. I'm not doing that. I'm just not that girl. I'm not that type of person. And people, when I used to work at Nightlife, they used to be like, oh, Destiny, you so shy. No, I'm not shy. I just don't know y'all like that. Like, people in Nightlife expect you to kiss their butt because they're this, this, that. And I'm not that girl, y'all. I swear I'm not that girl. Like, I would literally leave and go home and not come back here. And that's exactly what I did. Like, I don't go out like that because I feel like, it's, don't get me wrong, it's nothing wrong with going out, having a good time with your homegirls, with your friends, with your man, whatever. But I'm to the point in my life where I'm 22. Like, what am I going out every night for? What is that doing for me besides spending money? Like, I'm at the point, it's like, what are we celebrating? What are we celebrating? Unless I don't really have something to celebrate, why am I going out every night? And that's a real question. Like, a lot of people don't think about that, but that's a real question. Okay, y'all, so I'm done with the cons. That's basically it for the cons. And so we're gonna get into pros. It is some pros, you know, it's pros and cons to everything. But the pros is that you can make a lot of money in a little amount of time. Like, I ain't gonna lie. Like, when it was New Year's, like, when it was, like, a big holiday, like, Memorial Day, 4th of July, people want to be outside in the club. And you're going to make a bag. You're going to make a bag regardless. Like, when it's a holiday, you're going to make a bag. And that's the good part about it. But you have to realize you're not going to always make a bag. You're not. And I think that's where it got to a point where I was just like, I'm coming here, putting all my time into this, and it's not guaranteed that, you know, I'm gonna come home with a bag. And another thing that I really liked about being a bottle girl is you can, like, network so much. You can meet so many people. Like, it's just crazy. Like, I would meet all different type of people in the club. I would meet lawyers, doctors, like, not even just drug dealers or scammers. Like, it really be people in the club celebrating stuff that you connect with for real, for real. And that's another thing I like. I met a lot of people that I would have never met if I would have never been a bottle girl. And I'm just being honest. Like, seriously, I would have never met none of them if I wasn't a bottle girl. Another thing that I like, when I was bottle girl the whole year, that's all I did. Like, all I did was bottle girl. I didn't have no day job. No, nothing. So I would mainly, like, work on the weekends, but I had, like, the whole week to get myself together to be able to, like, you know, regroup. Like, I had the whole week to myself. And then when I knew the weekend come, I was about to put it in at work, like, back to work. But overall, I feel like I was a bottle girl in Charlotte. So I feel like being a bottle girl in Charlotte is different from being a bottle girl. And how can I put this? Being a bottle girl in lit cities. Like, it's different. Like, Charlotte is small, it's growing, but it's not no Miami. It's not no LA. It's not no Houston. And the stuff that I dealt with as a bottle girl in Charlotte, I can only imagine. I can only imagine how it is in big, big, big cities. Like, for I can only imagine how it would be for me. So, I don't know. Now, I'm not a bottle girl no more, y'all. I'm a bartender. Personally, I like bartending better because I have more control and I don't have to do as much. Like, with a bottle girl, I would have to be running all around to different tables at one time. And it would be a lot. I ain't gonna lie, it would be a lot. Like, it's not for the week. Like, you have to make sure your table's got juices, eyes. And in North Carolina, you have to pour your table shots. They can't pour it. We have to put it in a cage. So if I got four tables and they all got bottles, I have to be running around, make sure they're getting their shots, make sure they got everything they need. Like, it's not easy. It's not as easy as people make it seem. I'm telling you, like, you gotta be mentally strong to be a bottle girl, okay? But it was an experience. I don't know if I would do it again. Like, honestly, I don't know. But I'm really liking bartending because it's chill, laid back. Like, it's not as much as what bottle girls go through, I feel like. So I like bartending better. I'm still, like, bartending, like, in a club. But I eventually want to go to, like, a restaurant or something, like, that's real chill. And all of that, but I like bartending right now. It's real cool. And yeah, Nightlife, y'all, is not for the week. Like, I'm telling you, it'd be so much stuff you be going on, you wouldn't even know if you ain't ever been in Nightlife. Like, it'd just be crazy. Like, it'd just be crazy. But overall, it was a good experience for me. It was definitely, like, an eye opener because I thought I was gonna be wanting to do that still now, but now I don't. So I would just say, like, if you wanna be in Nightlife, just make sure that it's something that you really wanna do, and it's something that you not wanna do just cause other people doing it. Make sure it's something you really like to do. Make sure it's something you really wanna do because it is a lot. Nightlife is a lot, and it's not as easy as people make it seem. Like, I keep saying that, but it really not. But you do meet a lot of people. You meet celebrities that are actually cool. Like, it's pros to it and it's cons. I mean, that's with everything, even a day job. Like, I feel like that's life. But I'm gonna wrap this video up. I hope y'all guys like my video. I feel so excited about telling you guys about my experiences and my story times. If you guys want to see any videos about bottle girl, bartender, just comment below. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Y'all, I was on my chill vibes today because, yeah, I like to be on chill vibes, lounge. Yeah, no makeup. It's giving natural mommy. See you guys later. Yeah. Jumping Lexus like it's 07, I just hit a limit.